something like that a lot of times, you can see the crash coming, and I thought I was going to make it out of there fine. I didn't know I was going down until right before I hit the ground. Yeah, today's course, I felt like it really suited me. It wasn't quite as slick as yesterday. There was great traction out there, but there were still a few corners that were a little slippery, and there were two areas where you could bunny hop. Most of the guys were dismounting and running those sections, so you know, you could either gain a second or two or just save a little bit of energy by riding. But it ended up, you know, instead of being an asset today, it ended up stopping my race early. It was Powers and I off. We were together for a lap or two, maybe halfway through. We were going into the barriers, and I had led into the barriers a few times. Powers led this time. We have different techniques. I carry a little bit more speed through them, and so I had to deviate my line, cut into the middle of the barriers where it was muddier, lost all my speed, and kind of tagged the second barrier with my rear wheel, just catapulted over the bars, and I must have landed with my quad, right on the frame.
Wow. Oh,
shoot. And thought that I was gonna shake it off, get up, and it was kind of like a Charlie horse. I figured it'd get better, and I made it maybe 100 yards, and I couldn't move it anymore. And from there, it was a stretcher into the ambulance, an ambulance to the hospital for x-rays. But it's not broken, just a bad bruise. I know I'm a pretty big wimp, but I just wanted to make sure. I figured it wasn't broken, but I just wanted to make sure. And we'll see how quick the leg heals, and hopefully I'll be back on the bike in a few days. I don't think it'll have that much of an impact for nationals. I think it'll be enough time if everything heals quickly to stay on track.